Hello YouTube, this is Prash from X Accounting. Today I'll be showing you a very interesting spreadsheet this spreadsheet really helped me a lot in especially variance analysis between different datas every month over a period. So basically this sheet compares two sets of data in the same format and structure, mainly a columnar structure. It has to be a similar structure, and it gives you the difference between the data, mainly cell and row wise. So basically it compares cell wise and row wise data and gives you change in a separate sheet here, which I'm showing you here in the changes tab, changes sheet, and it will give you data with analysis and a tag added, add, remove and changes. I'll show you in a moment what exactly I mean. So you need to follow certain rules and to have accurate data analysis with this template. And here you can see I have old data, new data and changes. So old data is the data against which you're going to comparing your new data. So you can change its name in your macro, and I'll show you how exactly you can change these three names to your liking. So basically I kept it for example purpose so you can follow along easily. So as I have table with six column A to F with data ID, this is not a serial number, this is an ID, then employee name, first name, last name, email, gender and IP address. Similar way, I have a new data in the same format. So I have ID, first name, last name, email, gender and IP address. So this data is in same structure as you see A to F, here also A to F. So you must have same structure of data, especially in columns. Now the third sheet is called changes. Here the magic happens. So here your data will be copied in, your difference data, like added row, like number of data compared with the old data, what is added, what is removed and what has changed. So it also have a formatting applied to it, and it should have same structure. Only difference, there is one column for analysis. So this is an extra column. So in our case it will be B to G, unlike in the other two sheets is A to F. So it will have total 7 columns, but this should be same. So the best thing about this, you can add as many columns you want, but you have to follow structure. So columns of both data you're comparing, old and new, last one and this one, whatever you want to call it, it should have same number of columns and structure. Similar here, there would be only one extra column and rest of the column should be same. So this is the structure of the sheet. Now I have pasted here data, I will kept for example. I have actually similar data. So when I run this macro code with the button, it will do nothing. So let's try and do it. Nothing happened because there is data is similar. Now we'll do some manipulation by adding certain data. So I have some mock data ready here. So we'll be adding 10 more people in this list. So let's add this data to the new data. We'll go at the bottom. Okay. So don't confuse with this. This is a code, employee code. So it can be anything. So now we have added new data. Now, before you run any data, there is a button called clear data, which is a small macro which deletes all the existing analysis. So you always run that to have accurate data analysis. Now we have added 10 new people in the list. So it should come here as only those 10 people as addition. Now let's see. As you can see, it has come all these 10 people, which names Gregory. As you can see, I have added 291 from 291 to 300. These are total 10 people, the same name, all structure, all the rows have come here as a change. It's been formatted as a green cell background and white as a bold white as a color. So you can see 10 people are here, and you can also see add, because these are addition in the data in the new table. Now we'll try to do another analysis. We'll try to remove few people from here. And we'll change some data structure here. So I'll go to again to the sheet and I'll get some this data, this particular set of cells, and we'll just change them here. So only this cell has changed, but these cells are same, right? these people are same, but their attributes like email, gender, and have changed, right? Now we have a complete different table than the old one, right? We have addition, we have deletion, we have changes. So let's see how the macro will help you. So again, as I told you, we have to clear existing analysis. It is must, otherwise you won't be able to use this analysis at all. So let's run. As you can see, it has shown you the analysis, changes, what changes we did, number of employee deleted and number of employee added. So as you can see, whatever changes, that has been the cells which have changed, it has colored in brown, dark brown with a white font color. Red being deleted is in remove category. As you can see, I can just filter it here for you to show you guys. Yeah, so it is red background as a cell, and white, bold white is that font color. If I go to changes, yeah, so based on this you can populate lot of different reports. So this should be your first three tab, and then you can generate very detailed analysis of various data. So for example, if I'm doing employee payroll analysis and I want to compare the salaries and changes that happen between this month and last month, I can do a lot of manipulation. So this is a very important sheet and macro which I could able to find in one of the forum. I will link that particular forum in the description below. But I did corrected the code myself. There was some error popping up which I corrected. So my code, which I will also leave you this sheet as a template in the description below, in the video description, you can download and try it for yourself. Now I'll show you how to edit these names to your likings, and code will run anyway. So you have to go to your VB editor, which is Alt F11. So you will come here. So we'll go to compare data. This is the main macro, compare sheets. So here there are three names: old data, which is the name of that tab, as you can see here, old data. Then there is a new data here, it's available here, and there is changes. So you can keep only change these three names of the sheet as you want. So first change here, then copy paste that name here, old data, new data. So old data, so last month, new data this month, and changes. So I'm talking about in terms of payroll analysis. So like that you can change the names, and you can do your analysis accordingly. So this is a fantastic workbook, and this macro really kills a lot of analysis problem you may have, and it is a very optimized macro as well. So it won't consume, even if you apply the multiple sheet with formulas, the macro will run smoothly. As I have set macro in certain way that it will set your automatic calculation off while running the macro, which will really boost the speed of the sheet. So let me know, guys, your question or queries in the comment section below, and I'll be happy to help you out.